forgot to call you, dude. I'm starving, da. Let's go and eat out somewhere. Yeah, that's a cool place. I'll see you there in 5 minutes. Bye.
Moments later.
Oh shit!
Run.
Now that you have seen the consequences, let us actually dive into the reality as we take you along a compelling journey of Indian street food.
Indian street food is a perfect way to sample India's vast cuisine and culture. People fall for its relishing taste and instant availability. You get to stand around a food cart and watch the magic of vendors slinging ingredients together to make their local delicacies.
Behold, before you drool and dwell in its taste, also have a look at the hygiene and quality these magic vendors maintain.
Given all the odds and excuses, in a country like India, there is also a need to throw some light upon another perspective.
Sir, daily yeshtu gante inda bartira? Yeshtu
sigira? 12 gante inda ratri 12 gante gante
irthe. Yeah. Very good. Okay.
ಅವರು ನಿಮ್ದೆ ಇರೋರು ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲಿರೋರು ನಿಮ್ದೆ ಇರೋರು
Also, this more developed, organized, and standardized sector, the fast food joints.
A
an employee was kind enough to ensure the sanitary measures they took.
In oil, we are filtering every 2 hours, and after 3 days, we are discarding the oil and we are filling the new oil. Now, we have to wear the shower cap with any harmful items. We don't want to wear earrings and bangles and all. We should have to not wear.
Okay. Hopefully, many of our popular vendors are seemingly unaware of hygienic standards, yet are happy with their service.
Sanje 4 gantinda start agutte.
Okay.
4 gantinda start agutte. Sanje 10 gante vare iruthe matte dosa hogutte, masala dosa hogutte, sodda dosa hogutte, datta idli hogutte. Ella jana tumba ishta padtare.
Belagge college kadeyinda jaasti jana bartara.
Yaar kadeyindu jana jaasti bartare, maamuli public ku bartare. Ella kadeyindu bartare, ella jananu ishta padtidare. Ella ellaru chenagide anta helibittu hogtare.
I love the street foods, but you should not have random food because every time you keep having it, it's not good for the health. But occasionally it's very good because different tastes and all, I love the most. I come monthly once or 50 days once, and I really love few of the foods, not all. Better try everything and just let me know.
To be acquainted with the necessity of food safety and analytical quality control, we interacted with the concerned authority and drew out some conclusions.
Normally, when we talk about the food safety, there can be different types of concern. We call them as a hazards, food hazards or food contaminants. So, food hazards can be classified between physical hazard, chemical hazard, biological hazard. Physical hazard means maybe it is contaminated with some kind of physical attributes like pieces of wood, glass, metal, which during processing has come into the food. Chemical hazards, which could be due to different like heavy metals. Lead, cadmium, arsenic, mercury, which could come from the water. Probably it could be effluent water, which has come from the industry into the field, agricultural field, where these crops are cultivated, and these heavy metals are picked up by the plant, and then it comes into the similarly microbiological. Like we know that bacteria, fungus, mold, they are the severe concern to the food. If we don't store food into proper temperature or proper RH, then these microbes, bacteria, fungus, virus, they can contaminate the food. So that is the most severe concern, because effect will be seen immediately. To ensure that all the vendors, be it a street vendors, hotel, or anybody dealing with the food, selling the food, they need to enroll with the local authorities, which is in the corporation body, wherein they need to tell that my address is so and so, my foods are so and so, I am selling such kind of food, ownership, who is the owner, and what kind of precaution we take to make sure that food is safe. Most commonly, the problem comes from the water. If your water is not potable, if your water is not hygienically processed, then it is chance that it may have some kind of microbes which can come into the food. Secondly, if your handlers, people who are handling the food, if they don't follow the sanitary practices, if they don't use the gloves or mask or maybe all those protective garments, so if they are infected with certain things, like suppose somebody is infected with typhoid or some handlers, so then it is likely that the contagious microbes can pass on from person to the food. As a common man or as a student, especially because we are educated people, we should be aware what are the regulations, what are the norms. So first I would like all of you to go to the website of FSSAI. Check that what are the various norms, quality parameter, safety parameter, and be aware first of all. Then what are the provisions where as a common man, what are the empowerment you have it, and then impart the knowledge to others. First we need to be aware. Again, when we go to anywhere like hotel or any restaurants or any factory, we need to also make them aware, because India is a such country, unlike other countries. Like when I talk about the other countries like US, Europe or Australia, food business is largely organized business. There, most of the bigger companies make the food. So their implementation is much easier. While here, India, it is not so. Food is a business where family scale, tiny scale, medium scale, people who make in the family some kind of pickle, sauces, papad, appalam and all those kind of things. So obviously, a sector is not organized. So implementation is not easy here. It is a challenging task because the person who are doing that kind of business, like a street vendor, they are not educated enough to understand all those things. First of all, they may not know whether I am contaminating the food. He will not know whether I have to use the aprons or I have to use the mask and all those things. So he need to be made aware. So because our inherent problems are there, because sector is not organized and people who are involved, they are not educated, so they need to be made aware. So I would expect that all of us who are educated can, up to the extent possible, pass on that information to them so that they are aware and contribute